Hello, staff, Windsor families, and students. My name is Pete Sullivan, and I'm the Director of COVID Mitigation for Windsor Unified School District. Here are the updates for this week. Site-level COVID adjustment updates. Windsor Unified School District is making adjustments at every site in order to improve our COVID response. Windsor High School has hired a new health aide, welcome Gail, and a new phone-in RN to support our office staff and students. Windsor Middle School has hired a new CNA to support their staff. Welcome, Ariel. Cali Calmeca, in addition to hiring new staff, is ordering 16 10 by 20 tents and new lunch tables to increase distancing at lunch. They're also looking for lunchtime volunteers to help our youngest students adhere to masking and recycling policies at lunch. Brooks. After this week, Brooks Elementary School will have an RN on-site Monday through Friday from 10 to 3 daily. Welcome Marilyn, Sharon, and Crystal. Maddie Washburn has just brought in a new bilingual CNA who has helped smooth office protocols and congestion. Welcome, Jennifer. Our Windsor Unified School District nursing staff, shout out to Kim Marr, Jennifer Bowen, and Suzanne Rakowski for helping create new protocols for intake and return of students. Thanks to our mobile testing team for working with Brooks Elementary School and Maddie Washburn to support our staff testing with mobile team. Thank you, Christina, Raquel, Rachel, Jennifer, and Michelle. Student vaccination and testing submission option through Crisis Go. Windsor Unified School District hopes to open our student proof of vaccination portal soon. This will be voluntary. The submissions will help families with vaccinated students avoid repeated vaccination card submissions following quarantine notifications. It will also help us target unvaccinated students when notifying families of a campus exposure. Stay tuned for updates. In addition to optional vaccination submissions, we are working on using Crisis Go to message families when testing is required due to close contact or display of symptoms on campus. Once up and running, we will be sending parent COVID notifications through Crisis Go with links for testing registration and COVID protocols. The testing link will allow parents to get direct results rather than having to contact a site for a negative result. Crisis Go. Staff, please do not delete emails from Crisis Go. These emails contain important information regarding your vaccination status and testing requirements. Today is the deadline for testing results submission. If unvaccinated staff have not submitted results by the end of the day today, they will receive an update email from Crisis Go. Please read it carefully. Here's some good news. Our district-wide weekly case average is 8 active cases per week. Our student population is roughly 4,800 students. That means our percentage of positive cases per week is 0.0017. As of today, we have 0 cases of transmission tracked back to our campuses. Remember that our campuses are one of the few places where students are supervised, have a consistent masking policy, and enforcement. Our campuses are safe, and our staff is doing an excellent job of continuing to adjust to the constantly changing guidelines. Our mitigating strategies are working. Thank you all for your hard work. Masks. I'd like to remind fans at our indoor sporting events that you should be wearing your mask at all times unless you are actively eating or drinking. Please help keep our event safe for all who attend. And now I will read a message from our superintendent, Jeremy Decker. Windsor Unified School District is committed to following all the rules, mandates, and guidelines from our local, state, and federal health department and other governmental entities to combat COVID-19. On Friday, October 1st, Governor Gavin Newsom announced mandatory vaccinations for school children to help combat COVID-19. Details are still emerging, and it is, as yet, unclear exactly when these rules will go into effect. However, as Windsor Unified gains a clear understanding of timelines and requirements, we will share them with our community. While we support vaccination as an effective way to end the pandemic, the details of how this will be accomplished, where the necessary additional funding and staff will come from, and what other effects this might have on the district are not yet clear. It is likely the district will see an increase in independent study requests as some families decide not to vaccinate. Please know that we are working hard to understand our responsibilities and craft a plan for managing the future needs of our students and families. As soon as we have something more concrete, we will share it with you. Thank you.